Hey everybody, it's Professor Williams, and today we're going to look at the expected value of perfect information. When we talk about EVPI, expected value of perfect information, we're really talking about how much a decision maker will pay to know with certainty which state of nature will occur in the future. And so we have a few things that we make as underlying assumptions. And one is that the information is available. We also assume that the information is accurate. And we also know that as long as the EVPI is less than the expected monetary value without this information, the decision maker is going to go ahead and pay for the information. In order to find EVPI, the first thing we have to do is determine the expected monetary value of the decision alternatives. We're going to select the highest EMV for all decision alternatives. The next thing we're going to have to do is find the expected monetary value if we have this information. So the idea is that if I knew which state of nature was going to occur, I would simply select the highest payoff under each state of nature. So we're going to find those highest payoffs under each state of nature, and then we've got to weigh them by the probability of that state of nature occurring. We're going to sum those weighted payoffs, and that's going to give me the expected monetary value with perfect information. The last step is that the difference between the expected value with perfect information and without perfect information is the amount that a decision maker will pay to actually know the future. So I want to know how much I'm willing to pay for perfect information regarding my hot dog cart decision. I have three alternatives. I can open a small, medium, or large hot dog cart here on the Outer Banks. And I know that there are three states of nature possible. Tourist traffic will either be lower, the same, or higher than last year. I've also been able to construct a payoff table that gives me my payoffs for each of my three decision alternatives under the three potential states of nature. So I've calculated my expected monetary value without perfect information. So I have my probabilities that are associated with my three states of nature. 30% chance tourist traffic is lower, 50% that it's the same, 20% that it's higher. Remember, I'm going to weigh each of my payoffs by the probability of that payoff. And so I've simply multiplied these together, and then I'm going to sum them. This is the sum of the weighted payoffs. And in order to find my EVPI, I've got to select my decision alternative with my highest expected monetary value, considering that I have no information about the future. Now I'm going to look at my expected monetary value with this perfect information. Remember, that perfect information is going to tell me which state of nature is going to occur in the future. So the first thing I do is I go into each state of nature and I select the highest payoff under each state of nature. I'm then going to weigh that payoff by the probability of the payoff. So I've taken each of my highest payoffs and I've multiplied it by the probability of the payoff, and so that gives me my expected monetary value with this perfect information to be the sum of these weighted payoffs, or $164.50. Now what I need to do is I need to find the absolute value of the difference between my expected value with and without the perfect information. That's going to give me EVPI. Well, remember when I knew which state of nature was going to occur, the sum of those weighted payoffs was $164.50. When I didn't know which state of nature would occur, my expected value, my highest expected value, was $127.50. So the difference between my expected value with the information and without the information is $37. So that is the most that I will pay to know with certainty which state of nature will occur in the future. And what we know is this is the EVPI, or expected value of perfect information. Thanks for watching.